Hi everyone, this is Ray with the education team from Swirly Doo's Kit Club, and I'm going to share with you the box that I'm making from the tech kit from the September 2014 kit. Vintage Love. Sorry. Okay, so for reveal day, you saw, if you looked at the video, that I showed you how to use these Mod Melt molds. We got some metallic glue stick Mod Melt things. And I showed you some tips on how to get these molds to be clearly done like this. And you use wax paper, or that's how I did it at least. And so that was the focus of my last video, and now I'm going to show you the box. So also in this kit, the tech add-on, you also get rub and buff. So what I've done with this box is because it's going to be in here like this. So I'm going to use the same finish that I used on the inside of the box for the outside too. And here's what I've done. I've taken black gesso that we got in the mediums add-on, and I roughly brushed onto this part of the box, and there you can see the craft part. See, like in here, you can still see that. And then after that was dry, the gesso dries really quickly, I went ahead and added some rub and buff to it, and this is in Spanish copper. So I think that the camera is picking that up. I see a kind of a glare, and you can see the copper on there, but you can also see the black, so it really looks like it's faded. It's kind of a cool finish. So I'm going to go ahead and do that for this too, but I'm also going to cover this up with, or I'm not going to cover it up, but I'm going to be using these two. And I'm going to go ahead and put a black gesso finish on the whole thing, including these. So I'm going to glue these on first. And I'm actually going to be using some stuff from my stash too. These are some Tim Holtz industrial stickers, and I just wanted to add them just to make it a little more decorative. Okay, now that that black gesso is dry, I can go ahead and add some rub and buff. I'm just going to pour this into a little piece of plastic. This is a pretty dark copper. I'm going to use just a piece of cloth. I like to take old socks that have mismatches or holes and cut them up into little pieces. It's kind of a perfect cloth for this, and I just dip it in to the rub and buff. Get a pretty good amount on there, and it just kind of depends on how you want it to look. So I'll just show you on the bottom. You can do different strokes like this, get a lot of it off of your cloth, and then rub, and you can go into circular motions if you want to, which gives you a more solid finish there. Or you can just go back and forth, like I've done on here. And both ways are nice. I've kind of used a combination of both on here. Now I want to sand over some of this part. And that is the finish that I am going for. So then I can close my box and move on to embellishing. Alright, now that I finished my box, and I did this off camera, I took my distress tool and I went around and got a little bit more of the edges just to add some more dimension to that, more distressing. So what I want to do with the inside of the box is I want to add some of these tags. So basically, I'm just going to glue them in there. They're going to be part of the permanent decor on the inside of the box. And I want to add this vine that came in the flower add-on. I think it's a little too big as it is like that. It's a little bit intimidating there, so I'm going to cut off this bottom part right here. And that's it. I'll glue this on and I'll be done with my little shadow box using the Mod Melts and the nice rub and buff with the little box that came in the kit. Thanks for watching.